Okay, guys, so I talked to Hellwig, and they said that you could do one side at a time. So I did it. They said as long as you space your welds out and don't weld one spot too much, and as long as you run a ratchet strap, which I've done here. I welded the bars here like I showed in the previous videos, but I took a ratchet strap from here, ran it all the way across to here, tightened it up, pulled in tight, made sure my measurements were good, and then I started welding that thing in. So I welded this seam right here, this seam up here all the way across, boxed all that in, boxed all this in, and the bottom too. Now I just want to show you guys the difference. This is the basic stuff here. This is just this front plate welded in here from the Hellwig kit. And this piece here is just kind of tacked in like they said to do. You pretty much want to tack everything. And as you guys notice, I've galvanized the inside of this thing. But anyway, I just want to show you the flex. So I got my foot down on this thing and you can see how much flex is in that chassis. You see it twisted? Alright, quite a bit. Now you go to this side, that bad boy ain't moving a damn inch, not even a millimeter. I mean, I could stand straight up on it, and it ain't even so much as even thinking about it. So this kit, if you weld it in like they say, and you follow the instructions, that bad boy will be welded in and it will be strong. That one is from Hellwig, they say. You have this piece here from the factory piece. There is a doubler like this from the factory that went in here and there, and you cut it off. And then the purpose is to put this plate in there. Well, then you come across this seam here, there, and here, and you draw your reference line all the way across this thing here, and you trim it flush. Hellwig says, put this plate in here, tack it there, tack it in the corners, tack it there, weld a half inch bead there, and a half inch bead here. And then, I mean, of course, you know, due to trimming, you gotta trim it to make it kind of more or less work. So don't, you know, do a bunch of overhang, you gotta trim it. But then, you put this piece on, and it says just to weld a little 3/4 inch bead there, a little 3/4 inch bead here, and I've tacked it on the top and the bottom to make sure. Now what I did was, is I measured from this hole, and I took the width of this, and I centered it. It's pretty easy to do. You mark your reference from the bottom side here. I'll show you. So, as you can see, I made my reference mark here. All right, and then I measured half the width of this and made me two witness marks, and I made sure that these two gussets that they've got, or these two little flanges or whatever they are here, lined up with them holes in the set, and then I tacked it into place, and then I measured to verify to make sure everything looked good. And then you put this piece in, which it goes flush, then it's got like a little C that goes up in here, and then it comes out to this right here, and they tack that into place. Now that's what Hellwig says to do, and they recommend that you go right ahead and burn this top end. So as you can see, I did a little inch weld here, a little weld there, a little weld there, a little weld there, and I welded it all in solid here. And then they have these bottom pieces like this. And so these bottom pieces, as you can see, they kind of go in here like that. And this notch, as you can see, that notch kind of goes like this. And then you try to flush it up here. All right, once you do all of that, you get it squared up, and then you tack it into place, but you've got to trim this thing to make it work. So I'll do that now, and then I'll show you where I'm at. All right, guys, as you can see, I've got the front tacked in now. Now here's a mistake I made, and I'm gonna show you guys. I trimmed off this end like I told y'all not to. I did it anyway, and I end up making a little gap in there. So that goes to show you guys that you need to follow the instructions, life lesson. Now that right there was a notch that Hellwig had put in there so you can bend that thing around to close this gap up right here. Now, I don't use that. That gap is closed up back in here, and it follows the body line under there, the chassis itself, and I will fill that all in. I'm gonna leave this here open, a hole. I'm not really worried about filling it in, but as you guys can see, I got some tacks in there. Now this thing is ready to go. I'm also gonna tell you guys that these factory brake line bolts are gonna have to be relocated. They're not gonna be able to stay there because you're gonna close them in on both sides here. So you can pull those bad boys out and relocate your brake lines. You can relocate them somewhere else. All right, guys, the Hellwig kit is installed. All I got to do now is, it comes with a kit, is a transmission mount pad for your cross member to sit on. That you got to install that, but I'm going to wait to install the engine and the transmission first to make sure I get this thing oriented right. But other than that, this is pretty straightforward, guys. As you can see, I welded spot. You can kind of see where I've just done a little bit at a time. I welded all that in tight up underneath the bottom and welded this seam, like I said before, closed everything in real nice and tight. Another tip, guys, is that some of these factory seams, like back in here, are pretty sorry. It probably do you some good to weld up some of them seams as well, like around here, around the lower control arm mounting pads. The welds in there are really pretty sorry, so I would think maybe grind some of that stuff out, put in some nice beads in there and weld you a gusset in there to keep that all nice and strong. But other than that, guys, this is it. I took the ratchet strap off so you guys could see, the finished product. But I think it turned out pretty good overall. And this thing ain't even trying to move an inch. So it's definitely an upgrade from the factory chassis. And after everything's said and done, it looks pretty good. I'm happy with the results. Remember to like this video, please, and subscribe. And there will be future videos on rear end work, changing this over to disc brakes all the way around. Same thing up here. I'm gonna put some Global West A-arms, tubular A-arms, and some drop spindles and coilovers. So keep in touch for that. And I will be eventually putting in this Hellwig tie-in piece for the cross member. So keep subscribing for that, and I hope you guys have a nice day. Thank you. Girl, when I freak you out, I promise that you won't wanna get off.